Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. President Shavkat, on behalf of my delegation and myself, I want to especially thank you. Your generous hospitality, the way you have welcomed our delegation, we're all overwhelmed by your hospitality. So first of all, I want to thank you for that. This is my first visit to Uzbekistan, and inshallah, not my last one. I can tell you that my delegation and I are very excited about, first of all, coming to Tashkent, because for that famous, in 1965, the meeting that took place between the Pakistan president and the Indian prime minister. And so we all remember, I mean, I'm old enough to remember Tashkent. So firstly, coming to Tashkent, but secondly, we are all excited about going to Bukhara and Samarkand, because as children, we have read, learnt about it, its history. So this is also, I thank you. It's a great opportunity for us to see these two most historical cities tomorrow. Today we had extensive talks, and our talks were on the trade, connectivity, cultural, spiritual, and political. So we had such long talks that by the end, Mr. President, I was able to almost understand half of what you were saying in Uzbekistani. Because Urdu is so close to your language, I'm sure that more meetings and I will be able to understand all of it. We won't need an interpreter. So first, about the economic cooperation. Both of us on the same path. And Mr. President, you're talking about new Uzbekistan, near Uzbekistan, and we are talking about near Pakistan. The journey is the same. Number one, we want to lift our people out of poverty. We want a bottoms-up approach rather than a trickle-down approach, which has been traditional. So we are on that journey where we are trying to pull people out of poverty. And this is the model of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the state of Medina. He is the first one who started a welfare state. Even when they did not have money, the concentration was that a state only prospers when everyone prospers, when it's an inclusive development. And China recently has proved that if you take the people out of poverty, the whole state becomes rich. So we are on that same journey. I know you're concentrating on education and lifting your people out up from their current economic situation. Secondly, we have now changed emphasis from geostrategic to geoeconomics. Our whole idea is that we have to create wealth. If we create wealth, then we can spend it on our lower strata of the society and lift them up. So this is extremely important for us, that we now have strong trading relationship with Uzbekistan, which is the biggest country in Central Asia. This will benefit both of us. It'll be a win-win situation for both Pakistan and Uzbekistan, the stronger we improve our trading ties. So, Mr. President, you can imagine the amount of interest in Pakistan for the trading ties and the economic ties between our two countries. We have brought a delegation. It's one of the largest delegations ever of business community to come to go out of their country. We have brought 130 of our top business houses. And when I was leaving this morning on my mobile phone, I had messages from other business houses who also wanted to come today. So this is the beginning of, inshallah, a very powerful relationship between the two countries. And we feel that we can mutually benefit each other. We are really interested. Our business has signed a lot of MOUs, as you mentioned in your speech. We are really interested in help in agriculture because of your manufacturing agricultural implements, which Pakistan is now trying to upgrade its agriculture, which is basically an agricultural country. And secondly, cotton. We are going to seek help from you to improve our cotton seeds. The mutual benefit to the two countries will be Uzbekistan will have access through Pakistan. First of all, Pakistan, with 220 million people, is a huge market. And then onwards from our ports to Middle East and to Africa. And one day, inshallah, if our relationship improves with India, you will also have access to India. And Pakistan then has access to Uzbekistan, Central Asia, and beyond. So it is a very exciting relationship between the two countries. And so to connect, the two countries need to improve, number one, our air connectivity. And so for that, we have decided that we will try and increase the frequency of flights between the two countries. Secondly, through land, we have experimented that a truck has left Pakistan-Torkham border and has arrived in 2 days to Uzbekistan. So land connectivity, but most of all, and I know it is your brainchild and your passion, the railway from Uzbekistan, Mazar-e-Sharif to Peshawar, an idea which we all feel in Pakistan extremely excited about. We think that this really would change everything if we can have this railway line. It will improve connectivity between the two countries and the transportation of goods. And so that, I assure you, President Shavkat, I will be pursuing it, my government will be pursuing it, and rest assured that we will try and push this extremely exciting project as much as we can. And we discussed the political situation in Afghanistan in details. We are both concerned as neighbors of Afghanistan that people of Afghanistan have suffered for the last 40 years. And as neighbors, we feel they are our brothers. There should be peace there. There should be a peaceful political settlement there. So we discussed that in details. And we also resolved that the neighbors, Uzbekistan, Tajikistan, Iran, Pakistan, and even Turkey, we will try and help facilitate a peace process in Afghanistan. And for that, we hope that our foreign ministers will first meet, and then we will go on and try have a summit so that we can stop what looks like a civil war. And finally, Mr. President, about the cultural aspect, this is extremely exciting that we have decided now to make a film on the first of the great Mughals, Zahiruddin Babur. His dynasty ruled India for 300 years. And during that time, India was considered one of the richest places in the world. 24 to 25% of the world GDP was from India. So it was superpower of its time under the dynasty of Babur. So I think people, the young people in Uzbekistan and in Pakistan must know this connection. This connection stayed for hundreds of years between this part of the world and our part of the world. And we feel that this film and similar films, not just this film, they will connect the people of the two regions together. And then we can think of films on Iqbal, on Mirza Ghalib. I never realized that Mirza Ghalib was popular here. And then Imam Bukhari and, you know, who we are all connected with in the subcontinent. So we hope that this will be the beginning of a strong cultural exchange between the two countries. And inshallah, as our countries get closer together, cultural exchanges get stronger, then, Mr. President, I will introduce cricket to the people of Uzbekistan.